The worship of the early Christians became known as liturgy. The Greek word can be loosely translated work or duty. Liturgy, worship, is the work of the church. For the early Christian believers, the world was not a place to be avoided. They saw it as their workshop. They understood that they were in the world in order to bring all the men and women of this world to the font of baptism, and to include them in the body of Jesus Christ, the church. Then, along with us, they could participate in the continuing work of Jesus the Lord. The church is now placed in creation as a scene of its very transfiguration. All things were created in Jesus Christ, Paul told the Colossians, and they're being recreated as his work continues through his body, the church, of which we are all members. The unfolding of all of this is what St. Paul calls a plan and a mystery. He told the Ephesians it was to bring all things together under heaven and on earth in Jesus Christ. Beloved Father, through the life, death, and resurrection of your only begotten Son, Jesus the Christ, we have become your adopted sons and daughters. Through baptism, we are now members of his body, the church. Our Savior Jesus taught us that whoever does the will of my Father in heaven is my brother and sister and mother. We thank you. That promise includes each one of us. As members of the family of Jesus, we turn to you in prayer. In Jesus, we are joined in a communion of love which is stronger than death, along with the saints, the holy ones. They are the great cloud of witnesses the Bible speaks of. They've gone before us, marked with the sign of redemption, and they live their lives by faith. They inspire us by their holy lives. They also pray for us from their place in your communion of love. In a special place of honor in that communion is Saint Joseph. He said yes to your call to be the chaste husband of Mary, the mother of the Lord, the foster father of Jesus, and the guardian of the Redeemer. A man of few words, Joseph spoke with action and calls us to the way of active faith. The patron of all workers also shows us the dignity of all human work when joined to Jesus. Joseph always said yes to your invitations of grace. He always put Mary and Jesus ahead of himself. And he invites us to do the same in our own daily lives. The carpenter who taught the child Jesus to work with wood in the workshop of Nazareth now shows us that all human work participates in the loving plan of redemption. At 33 years old, Jesus, the carpenter's son, freely embraced the wood of the cross and reconciled us to you and to one another for the sake of the world. Joseph loved Jesus, and Jesus loved Joseph, and that love continues. Saint Joseph, you who love Jesus with a genuine fatherly love, we now ask you to pray for us as we follow the way of Jesus in our everyday lives. You understand the challenges of raising a family, earning a living, facing the difficulties of life, and always remaining faithful to God. We now turn to you and we ask for your intercession. By your prayers, obtain for us the special graces we need to be faithful to our own specific vocation and to live our lives in service to Jesus as you did. Saint Joseph, today, I specifically ask you, and now here, add your own specific intention. Glory be to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
đoàn con đến xin dâng thánh du xe, dâng trọn đời con, dâng khó khăn trong đời. Xin người dù thương, xin dạy gỡ giúp chúng con vững lòng cậy trông, con phó thác nơi người. Nguyện phó thác nơi thánh Giuse những khó khăn trong cuộc đời con. Nguyện phó thác nơi thánh Giuse, nguyện xin người giúp con bình an. Ngày đoàn con đến xin dâng thánh Giuse, với lòng thành tâm con phó dâng nơi người. Những chuyện buồn vui bao lo lắng trong cuộc đời, vững một niềm tin con phó thác nơi người. Nguyện phó thác nơi thánh Giuse những khó khăn trong cuộc đời con. Nguyện phó thác nơi thánh Giuse, nguyện xin người giúp con bình an. Con đến xin dâng thánh Giuse, sứ đạo của con xin phó dâng cho người. Xin người dù thương, thương nâng đỡ các gia đình, vững một niềm tin luôn mến Chúa yêu người. Nguyện phó thác nơi thánh Giuse những khó khăn trong cuộc đời con. Nguyện phó thác nơi thánh Giuse, nguyện xin người giúp con bình an. Ngày đoàn con đến xin dâng thánh Giuse, giao phận của con xin phó dâng cho người. Xin người dù thương, xin nâng đỡ, xin phụ trì. Giao phận của con phó thác nơi người. Nguyện phó thác nơi thánh Giuse những khó khăn trong cuộc đời con. Nguyện phó thác nơi thánh Giuse, nguyện xin người giúp con bình an. Nguyện phó thác nơi thánh Giuse những khó khăn trong cuộc đời con. Nguyện phó thác nơi thánh Giuse, nguyện xin người giúp con bình an.